Brachlira Merlon was born on Velorfor, a world within the Galente Federation, known for its vibrant culture and democratic ideals. But from the very beginning, her life was marked by a tragedy and isolation. Her mother died during childbirth, leaving her father to raise her alone. Yet, as Brachlira knew, it became clear that something was deeply wrong. Her behavior grew increasingly antisocial, characterized by violent outbursts and a chilling lack of empathy. By her teenage years, her father, unable to cope with her growing instability, disowned her. Brachlira was subsequently institutionalized in a series of mental facilities, where she spent the remainder of her youth. The Federation's attempt to treat her were futile. The institutions failed to contain her growing darkness, and upon reaching the legal age for a release, Brachlira was set free, unhealed, and more dangerous than ever. Upon her release, Brachlira vanished from the public eye. She crossed the Imperial borders, leaving behind the Galente Federation's democracy and ideals. Her destiny was the Blood Raider Covenant, a notorious pirate organization, infamous for its grotesque rituals and brutal raids. The Blood Raiders, worshippers of the Sanisabic faith, revered blood as a sacred element, often harvesting it in horrific acts of violence. They saw in Brachlira's kindred spirit a woman whose capability for violence and disregard for life aligned perfectly with their own twisted beliefs. For years, Brachlira disappeared into the shadows of the Blood Raiders' domain. Now, what transpired during this time remains largely unknown, but when she re-emerged, it was with a newfound purpose, a deep, fanatical loyalty to the Covenant. Brachlira was no longer just a troubled young woman. She had become a weapon, a ruthless killer, dedicated to spreading terror and chaos in the name of her new masters. Brachlira's return to the public eye was as violent as it was unexpected. She led a brutal attack on the Federal Trade Convoy in the Covran system, far from the usual hunting grounds of the Blood Raiders. The attack was swift and devastating, leaving no survivors, marking Brachlira as a significant threat to the Federation. The Galente authorities, recognizing the danger she posed, placed her on the top 10 most wanted lists, where she has remained ever since. The raid on Covran was more than just an act of piracy, it was a message. Brachlira Merlon has embraced her role as a harbinger of the Blood Raiders' dark creed. Her attacks were unpredictable, her methods brutal, and her loyalty to the Covenant unwavering. To those who crosses her path, whether they were traitors, mercenaries, or even other pirates, often met a violent end. Her skill as a pilot was unmatched. Her capacity for violence seems to know no bounds. Brachlira's reputation as a sociopath and a psychopath is well earned. She is a figure of pure malevolence, her actions driven by a twisted sense of purpose and an unyielding devotion to the Blood Raider. In the dark reaches of space, where the law is but a distant memory, Brachlira Merlon reigns as one of the most feared individuals in Uedon. Her story is not one of redemption or heroism. It's a tale of life twisted by tragedy, of a mind consumed by darkness, and of a soul irrevocably lost into the void. In the vast universe of Eve, where players and NPC alike shape the fate of galaxies, Brachlira Merlon stands as a reminder of the horrors that lurks in the shadows, and the price of embracing the darkness within. Her name, whispered in fear among the stars, will forever be associated with the bloodshed and the terror that she left in her wake. And as long as the Blood Raiders continue their grim crusade, Dracula Merlot's legacy will live on as a dark beacon to all who dare to walk the path of destruction. And if you see the blood-stained apocalypse in space, you now know who she is.